Well, continuing on with my 3080 Ti, I'm starting to do some rig planning because the temperatures are doing nothing but increase outside. And this is the kind of les refusés rig, just cards that are extras, and there's Jada again. but anyway, I'm becoming more and more a fan of matched rigs, so the exact same, the exact same model anyway, not necessarily the same AIB in a rig, and I've got one in my garage which has kind of a different mix match of cards. So I've got five non-3070s in there, and I'm realizing that I've got five 3070s in here. So I'm actually going to be pulling these five 3070s out of this RaveOS rig, and I'm going to run down and swap them into that, and I will let you guys know what I'm going to do with those cards as soon as I get down there. So let's go ahead and get down there, swap them out. Well, there's the rig in question. Steven Cicero will, Cicero? Whatever. He'll be happy that we're in the garage, even though there was no car video this week. So let me yank that out real quick, and we'll see what the arrangement is and how we want to lay those out. Okay, so I believe that's our 70 Ti, so that'll come out. These are CMP 40 HXs, these will come out, and those are both 2070 Supers, which also come out. I'm going to double check in the dashboard real quick just to make sure that's correct. But I'm also probably going to move the FTW and the TUF to the ends, as those seem to be the worst cooled for some for whatever reason. So most of this is actually going to get moved around a little bit. Whatever. Okay, so we've got the 3070 Ti, two 2070 Supers, we have an XC and an FTW3, and two CMP 40HXs. And there are our five slots. So I think I'll go blower, XC, blower, blower, blower. Should be fine, or maybe I'll put the XC there. Doesn't really much matter, I don't think. Just the big coolers on either end. She's a beauty, Clark. All right, let's see if it fires up. Okay, well, it at least fired up. We got primarily flux. The bottom two cards are on Kapow. I'll probably switch that around and keep Kapow on the 40HXs because they're about as good as a 3070 and the same power, so it doesn't seem to make sense to waste a 3070 on that, but the stack of GPUs is ready to come home with me, and at least everything can have the exact same OC on it, so pretty happy with that. Alright, so we have everything back. It's in the RaveOS rig here at the house, and I decided since, well, one of the 2070 Supers isn't even showing up, I don't know which one yet, I have to just figure out exactly what's going on with either the power delivery or the card seating there, but also the CMP 40HXs, you can see those are not great thermally. I have the fans set at a static 66, and I feel like they should be doing better on temperatures, especially considering they're in a server case. So I'm actually going to pull those out in order, mark them, and I'm going to repaste them with two different thermal pastes. So we'll take a look inside, and then we'll also see if there's any noticeable difference between Prolima Tech PK3, and I have Arctic Silver 5 as well in this pile somewhere that I'll dig out, which is my personal favorite and has been since 1998. So let me shut down the rig. Let's get those cards out, plopped right here in order, and let's see how much we can improve those thermals on those CMP 40s. Also, I figured out which 2070 Super was not running. It's the FTW, which got pulled out of the slot with the pressure on the the power connectors. Whoops. This case is a little bit shipping damaged, so screwing the cards in is very difficult. Oops, the daisy. All right, so I've paid attention to which one is which. We're going to put Arctic Silver 5 in this one and Prolima PK3 in this one, and let's see what kind of deltas we're working with. Well, after like a billion warranty void stickers, yeah, already gross. Thermal pad oil through the backside of the flip chip, and lots of dirt built up. So, doesn't look like there's too much to it. I think we will have to undo the I/O bracket and then the four spring-loaded clips on the actual heatsink, but back plates come off just fine. You can see the numerous warranty void if removed stickers, which are hilarious because they're not enforceable, and there's no warranty on these anyway. I actually spoke too soon, and boy, those are lined right up for server case use. So if you have a CMP 40HX ASUS card, there you go. There's the fan model. I'm sure these are the same as 1660s. Notoriously terrible fans, but again, mine are actually in okay condition. These are okay, as long as you don't run them above 80% fan, in my experience. Only two little plugs on them. I'm going to flip this back over, take the four spring-loaded clips out, and we'll see what we got. Yuck. Yuck, 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 yuck. And yeah, the thermal paste is rock hard. So you can see the nice imprint in there. I'm going to get that cleaned off as best I can, repaste it. Thermal pads are actually okay feeling. Definitely not going to replace them. I'm not mining ETH with these cards anyway. I will probably put some backside pads on here, but I'm very much of the opinion if a card's working, don't mess with it too much. So mainly just to clean up and repaste. You can see the TU106100A1 die there. When I first tested these, I said they were kind of a 2060 Super. That's not inaccurate, but the more I looked at it, the CUDA core count and the TMUs are actually dead on with a regular 2070. So these are 2070s. You can tell they're all micron memory, unfortunately. A Samsung one would be awesome, but it doesn't seem to matter as much with these, especially because you can't lock the memory under 5000 anyway.
It's so gross. It's just so icky.
Well, I added some backside thermal pads as well. These are 2 mil. Looks like they're a little bit too small. Not sure if they're going to do much. Looks like 2.5, maybe 3 would be better there, but whatever, they're in. Certainly won't make it any worse. So this is the Arctic Silver 5 card. I'm going to go ahead and prep this one now.
Uh-huh. Looks like one of these might have already had new fans put in it, and I'm guessing it's the other ones because they were cleaner.
So these are still ball bearing and they still feel fine. But yeah, still a very, very dirty card. It's odd though, it does look like there are still traces from the GPU to the display outs, not to the HDMI, but potentially to the DVI. That's just weird. It's kind of cool, I'm seeing test points. It's actually a really, really great idea. Cool. The paste is ever so slightly better on this card. Still really bad, rock hard. But yeah, the dirt, yuck. Just yuck.
Well, this scientific test isn't very scientific, because although I did use different pastes, I'm trying 3 millimeters on this one just to see if they fit, so... Still, they both needed a repaste.
Yep, if you have one of these dual CMP40s, 3 or maybe even 3.5 millimeter are the play. But 3 looks like it's actually pretty good.
Alright, same order. Let's get these booted into Rave.
So this is a little bit peculiar. This was 62 before, and that was 71 before. This is also the card that's sandwiched right by the power supply, so I'm wondering if... I don't know. I'm going to flip them around and make sure that I didn't just screw up the repaste. This is the Arctic Silver card. This is the PK3 card.
I'm actually noticing that this mining case is not in order, like the Vitretus, so I'm not positive which card it is that is misbehaving. But yeah, it's definitely the card, not the placement, so... I may have to set the fans at 100 and find out which one it is, and then take a second look at it. The paste application, I spread it to all corners of the die, so I'm not exactly sure what's going on there. The Arctic Silver 5 is considerably thicker paste, so I'm wondering if it needs some time or more pressure application to get it happy. But yeah, that's not good. 71C. I will say the hash rates and the wattage is actually, it's seemingly better now. Not really sure what to make of that.
Well, it's been a few days since repasting both of the 40HXs. The temperature is still a little bit higher on one of the two cards, but it's also right against the center PSU. And they're both producing just about the same number of shares, same wattage. The bin has actually improved on one of the cards quite a bit after the repaste, so it's making me think any card that I have that's underperforming, I might just need to repaste it. But anyway, that's good news. I'm happy. They still do okay on Flux.